Welcome to Break. And now, a talent show.
The red hand signaled us not to walk, even though half the group already did. My friend Xavier and I paused, waiting for the sign to tell us when to move. All the cars were stopped, and our friends waved us over. It seemed like a safe scenario, so we decided to walk. While we made our way, out of the last lane came a silver car heading straight for us. All of a sudden, everything turned black. I couldn't see anything, but only could hear the sound of my body slamming into the structure of the car, glass breaking, cars honking, people screaming, and lastly, the scariest sound was my skeleton hitting the hood, the windshield, and lastly, the ground. I lie awake on the cold sidewalk with dirt and gravel grounding to my face. I look up, tired and confused. I see my friend Antonio sitting over me as I look at him with my eyes half closed. I say to him, "I'm really tired and all I want to do is go to sleep." He looked at me and said, "You have to stay awake. Please stay awake. You got into an accident and everything's going to be okay soon." I replied, "Okay, please call my mom." I lifted my shattered phone, gripped my bloody fingers, and hoped for the best. Soon, my parents came rushing to the scene, jumping into their cars and getting there as fast as they could. Antonio asked me a series of questions to keep me conscious while the ambulance was on its way. Soon, the ambulance arrived. I could hear my mom shouting through the crowd, yelling, "That's my daughter, let me through right now." Instantly, a feeling of comfort and safety came over me, knowing that my mother was there. Soon, the pain started to show and my adrenaline wore off. Pressure came shooting to my head and body as the sensation of blood trickling down the back of my head shivered me with fear. I asked the medic repeatedly, "Am I okay? What's gonna happen? Will I survive?" Soon, I ended up at the hospital, where my parents were informed that there was a 10% chance of me living. My parents walked in the room as they were told to say their last goodbyes, and they looked at me and smiled, reminiscing on my childhood, telling me how much they loved me, with tears streaming down their faces. Then my brother Matthew walked into my room. He looked very scared, and he stood by my bedside, giving me a blank stare. Honestly, I was happy to see Matthew because he was the only person I wanted to see. I know that he could make me feel better and crack jokes and instantly I would feel okay, and that's exactly what he did. The recovery was extremely hard, but I've been asked now if I would take it back or if I wish that it never happened. I would take back the pain and the suffering, but I would not take back the experience. I learned a lot about myself that I would not know if I didn't go through this. I guarantee that I would not be the same person I am today without it. I look around and I see a great life that I'm lucky to live. I have loving family and friends that support me, a great school with amazing opportunities and experiences. This experience was a push that I get every time I wake up in the morning to realize that life is good. It's that little thing that makes me realize if something is going wrong in my life, I know that I can overcome it if I truly put my mind to it.
Which is super exciting. They're still willing to take a couple more. See me today if you want an application and go through that process. But I do want to recognize those 15 and see. That's so exciting. So please stand up. Don't come up here. Just stand where you are. Danica, Jerry, Francis, Anushka, yes. Campbell, Julia Ortiz, Kevin King, May, Wanda, Alex Way, Lily, Jonathan Zhao, Nicole K, Emily Pates, service learning opportunity. I'll be offering one starting after spring break. I'll have all the forms and such after spring break. The students that we're going to be helping are going to be on spring break when we return, so that's the little connection. But it was with the Village Project. They are an organization based out of Seaside that does a lot of work for the community there. And so the opportunity is to tutor and work with students that are kindergarten through fifth grade. We'll be going on Mondays, every Monday after spring break, from 2:45 until about 4:30. I'll be driving a van over and back. You have to attend the orientation. You need permission forms both for York and for the Village Project. So there's a lot of little things to work out. But come see me if you're interested. I'll be outside after break.
So, thanks for clapping at that performance we had earlier. So we're all so supportive here at York, and we're going to be just as supportive at the talent show that's going to be happening later this month. So thank you for everyone that signed up. And today is the last day, Ms.
Right.
Williston, for you to sign up. Please wait here at break and come up and we'll sign you up. We'll talk, tell you everything about this. So it's going to be a great time. Sign up if you want to do it. Today is the last day. Thank you so much. Go to class. Yeah.